What's up, guys? Jimmy or Chaos, welcome back. And I want to just talk to you guys for a couple minutes about how Call of Duty has changed over the years. And this isn't new news to anybody, but I wanted to give my thoughts on some of it. And it was kind of not triggered in a negative way. The conversation piece kind of stemmed from what you see on the screen here. And this is Call of Duty Siege, which is a new mobile app game that just got soft launched in Australia, I believe. And the game plays from IGV. He was nice enough to let me use this, so check out his channel. Link in the description if you want to go watch it in its entirety. And I got on the computer this morning to start my normal stuff, looking on social media, and Charlie Intel had tweeted out about a new Call of Duty game. And I'm like, what? Of course I'm going to go take notice and see what's up. And they did an article about it. Call of Duty Siege is a new Call of Duty card game. That is right. Call of Duty is now getting into the mobile card game scene. And this thing soft launched on iOS in Australia. I was like, okay, I need to go check this out and see what it's all about. I think Call of Duty Heroes was the last mobile app game. I'm not for sure. And you could connect with that one because it had like Price and Soap and Ghost and all them. So I was thinking, well, if I can connect with this, I'll check it out. Maybe it'll be something I want to take with me on trips on the mobile app or whatever. I don't know. And then I went and looked at it. And yes, it's Call of Duty, but it doesn't really connect like other Call of Duties. It's more cartoony, and yes, there are supply drops in this thing you guys see on the screen right here. I guess if you get a win, you get supply drops, and you want to get unique cards and battle other people and move up and all that stuff. So the supply drop system is in the game, and this is your normal type game. I mean, freemium type app where there's in-app purchases and all that stuff. But it got me thinking of where we were and where we are. And after looking at the gameplay and everything, I'm not hating at all, but it's not for me. I thought it was going to be something that I like COD history. I like nostalgia and all those things. And it just looks like they took a different course, if you will, making this game. But I wanted to share it with you guys, get your thoughts and opinions. And it got me thinking, like I said, where we were and where we are now. I remember sitting down and grouping up with buddies and playing World at War. And we would party up and play for hours. And it was fun, okay? It was good old-fashioned fun, even into Modern Warfare 2 and game battles. Black Ops 1, same thing. Parties, fun, banter back and forth on the mic. There was just, it was all, I guess, new and fresh in a way, but it wasn't new and fresh. It didn't seem to get old, okay? And then we fast forward to where we are now, and I've done videos about this in the past, how things have changed it drastically, and it's not just Call of Duty, it's the world around us. I mean, we're in 2016, and the world is not what it was 5-10 years ago. I mean, it's completely different, and it will continue to do that, but it just got me thinking. Playing World at War, Modern Warfare 2, Black Ops 1. Black Ops 1's where I really launched my channel. And now I'm sitting here talking to you guys in front of a Call of Duty mobile app game that you see. And it just, I don't know, maybe in the sense of I feel like a Call of Duty historian in a way. I do the top 10 COD history stuff, and we've done all types of stuff, like the Road to the Best, and all kinds of Call of Duty best maps, best guns, you name it. So I feel like I have a vested interest in a way in Call of Duty history. And then when I see this, and to me, it doesn't really connect at all. I mean, people say, well, why would they do this? Why would they make this game? Because that's why companies make games. That's why companies make products, to sell them and to make money. That's what companies do, and a lot of people just don't seem to understand that and connect the dots when it comes to companies and publishers and developers and video games. And it's not just Call of Duty, it's anything. And people seem to get that disconnect of, well, I'm a fan and I want it to be exactly how I want it to be, yet there's a business behind it. And a lot of people just can't seem to fathom, comprehend, or want to understand that. But yeah, I was watching the gameplay. Look at that. That's a rare supply drop. He got some platinum and assault calming card. I have no clue how this thing works. Like I said, it doesn't pique my interest at all. I'm not probably going to download it when it comes out. but I wanted to show you guys and kind of stem the conversation in the comment section about where Call of Duty started and where we are now. Do you like the progress? Do you like the change? Do you like the adaptation of now we have a mobile Call of Duty app card game? Or are you an old schooler and you're just like, man, I remember the good old days? And that's easy to do with anything, not just video games or Call of Duty. There's the whole, I remember the good old days, or the grass is greener on the other side. But I thought it would be a good conversation piece. Let me know what you guys think, and I'll see you later.